whatever government has given to us, so it's left for us now whether we will develop or keep.
That's
but
it.
By the special grace of God, God will bring somebody who will develop it.
Amen.
Is a community in Odomo Local Government Council under Edo State. So I was posted here for some time to head the library, and by the special grace of God, I'm doing well with it. See, this library was established around 1980 by the then governor of the state, Bender State, then called Professor Ambrose Folosho Ali, who's now late. So ever since then, the library has been going on very, very well. And it's been nurtured by successive governments, especially the present government, headed by the Comrade Governor, Comrade Adams Ali Oshomoli. And we've been getting fine management by the managers and directors of Edo State Library, whose headquarters is in Benin. So up till now, we have been cared for in terms of bringing our books, carrying off the staff and all that. So it has been very good. Except that there are things that we could also say. As at the time we are now discussing, I will tell you clearly that as a person in the helm of affairs of this Banker Library, we lack certain things. You see, it is clear, it is very clear to all and sundry that government alone cannot spearhead everything. And the government also makes it clear to all and sundry, especially communities, that whatever establishment cited in your community, it should take care of it. You do not allow it to waste, because it's your property. It's an opportunity for you to get sought. And you might look around and find that that same establishment, other communities like yours, big, even bigger than yours, may not have the opportunity of getting such an establishment in your department, in your community. So that is the more reason why the government says that any establishment made in your community, you should take care of it and let your community develop interest in improving on it. Like I said earlier on, that government has preached it once, time without number, that government alone cannot do everything. So because of that, I have many occasions taken it upon myself and my staff here to advertise our library, tell our people, especially the Banker boys and girls, who have really passed through the library, who are now successful in their various endeavors, lawyers, engineers, doctors, in fact, pressmen. We have many of them. And each time I come across them, I see it as an opportunity to tell them about the library, to help the government develop it. And that when you help the government, you also help your community. And the community, you help your children, you help your family there.
You can see the library now. We use our money to clear this area for since 4 or 5 years now. We've been using our labor, our salary to clear around the company.
If it is supply of textbooks, if it is supply of magazines, journals, even the newspapers.
You has give us two, or they do come to our help. They buy, so at times they buy for 1 month. This one now we say I will buy for 1 month. The other one now we now say I will buy for 2 months. Mm. After that, they will not come again.
Mm.
Like the Vanguard now is 150 naira per one. At times on Sunday, 200 naira. Mm. The other one is still 150. Because they do supply the national and the local.
Mm.
That is how they do it.
There are many others like that, who have promised and are not able to fulfill. But then, I've not lost hope that because each time I discuss this matter with them, so be hopeful. Be hopeful. So I come to be hopeful. So I know that one day God will touch their hearts and say, oh, this thing this man has been saying in their committee, they will try. So this is why I discuss any matter in faith and I discuss in hope. After our discussion, I see hope. Even as you are sitting here, I'm still hoping that if market boys and girls who have prospered, even not on academics alone, I discuss it with them, they will one day start coming to see the goodness of this library and they will contribute, give their quota. I'm still, like I've told you, I'm hopeful and I do everything in faith. To be fair with the government have been doing their best in sending me books, but for some time now, they have not been able to do that because of one or two things. I know government is trying. Our books are a little bit obsolete. Not that the government is not trying. Government is sending us books. But if the committee wants to send us books, then we will start looking at the obsolete issue or when last government came. No, government is trying. We can also help ourselves, even without knowing the limits government has done. We can still help ourselves. Even if government gives us today and you give us tomorrow or the same today, it is not bad. We are like the Oliver Twist. We see, ask for more and more and more and more. We are not even satisfied. In the past, the library's law used to be that no student comes in with his or her book to the library because the library is fortified with whichever book you need. Due to the situation we've now found ourselves, we allow the children to bring in their books because of the current books, which you have not really, like you asked now, like the current book which you have not really been able to get for this year, 2013, we still allow the students to bring in their books, their own materials, read their books, treat whatever they want to treat in their books, but that does not mean they will not have something to support whatever they bring in. They have support in the library to support whatever they have brought. So, in a nutshell, we allow them to bring in their books. Computer issue, we know, we are now in computer age. What the government has not given us any information as to whether they will computerize community libraries. Because the library in Edo State is much. If they really want to start computerizing all the community libraries, I'm not saying government cannot do it, but they have not started. Like I'm talking to you, I cannot boast of knowing what is the operational systems of computer, unless I'm taught, of course. Mm-hmm. So that I think that applies to many other people. If you do not know about it, unless you are taught. So to get to your question direct, if you bring in computer, we have to teach the people. But first of all, the children will be happy to see it. And because of the instinct, the happiness, they will be serious to learn. Issue of power is a general one in this country. There's nowhere that power is constant. Not to talk of a bank, a small community. We only say that government is trying. Government is trying. At the same time, many people say it, that the PHCN is currently not doing very well. It's currently not doing very well. So I want to say that I cannot pin it to a point. That is to say, what do we do with the computer thing if there's no, since there's no power or there's no constant power? I cannot pin it down, but I want to advise that whatever that is worth doing at all, worth doing well. I would not want to discourage you by saying that because power in this country is epileptic, therefore people will not develop their communities. No, the epilepticity of power in this country is even in Abuja, the federal capital. So that is my own input to that. This Ibanke community is no more a village. It has moved a little bit up, in the sense that the government of the day, led by the Comrade Governor Gono Somole, has made Igbanke become a town comparable to what takes place in other big cities. So, if our people were scared of coming home just because of the lack of infrastructural development, I would not blame them. I would not blame them because it's true that many people stopped their car elsewhere in the town and then maybe use the motorbike because their car cannot pass anywhere, cannot take anywhere. So they use bike and come. So I will not blame them. But that is the time passed. But for now, we have developed. We have roads. The infrastructure development in the Igbanke community is high. That I will encourage them to come. If anyone is still scared because of the posture of the community in the old, it should be told now that everything has changed for the better. We have roads. And by the special grace of God, nightlife will be very beautiful in this community because the Comrade Governor promised this town that as soon as these roads were completed, he will electrify all the streets that he has tarred. In fact, we have applauded that. And the Comrade Governor is one man who speaks and follows it up to the letters. We have high hope that he will do it. And any moment from now, when he electrifies these roads, you will almost find that nightlife in Igbanke will be more beautiful than the day life. And on that, he has promised bringing us three industrial boroughs which will serve the community. I learned that Women Vanguard, Igbanke Women Vanguard, headed by one late Kate Osaji, Madam Kate Osaji, spearheaded the establishment of this branch of the library.
Now they organize bring this library to Igbanke to help to start, even start the building before the meeting collapse. So nobody to erect the building again.
Well, I wouldn't go further than that because I was not here. But as you were told, I was also told. I stayed very much in Benin and headquarters as a librarian then before I was moved down here. In fact, before I was moved, the thing has already been established. So like somebody told you, so also I was told. And truly, due to the information we got, there is the undeveloped site of the library.
Proposed Edo State Library Market Branch. This is the place. They developed very well. In fact, the pattern is so big that if it were developed, in fact, we'll be proud that we have a standard library like what obtained in the big cities. But unfortunately, I don't know what made it to stop at this stage. And ever since then, I have been adding it as an appeal to our people to see if they can help develop it.
Where we are operating from now is a temporary one allotted us by the local government then.
For how long?
Well, the local government then established it and then made it a maternity. Made it a maternity. But I want to believe that because of the importance of the library and the government's pressure to give us one, they have to locate that side of the building to the library on a temporary basis, believing that in no distant future, the permanent building will be developed. But unfortunately, I don't know what really happened, that the committee couldn't continue with the building.
But how long have you been in that site now?
In fact,
because it's like the library has been there since 1979.
I suppose so.
And this is year 2013.
Yeah, 2000. It's long. It's very long. I was posted here in 1989, and about
1990, I was also moved to Ewohime Branch Library. And I came back in the year 2008. Also. So that is the question. So I cannot really know what really did. They gave that side of the building temporarily to the library.
But it's over 20 years anyway.
So to say. It's quite long. You know, it's quite long, yes.